Gurudev affirms here that the household life itself is an appropriate training field for spirituality. It is seen these days the subtle spiritual force yielded to the grosser physical force, and man's originality is considerably concealed. These invincible emotions have enslaved the man so much that he is bound to undergo rounds of human bondages. In order to set himself free from this soaring condition, man should seek the help of dhyana for restraining his mind, or to attain calm state of mind. Nature's main characteristic is equanimity. Promoting equanimity in us means our harmonious blending with nature. This is only the base essence of spirituality. As such, man's main motive is to gain control over his mental faculties through perfect and effective dhyana for his successful march towards God. This is possible only through Sahajamarg way of sadhana, which is simple and natural, superior and perfect in itself. The singularity in this system is to meditate on the heart, by reason that the activity of thought pertains to only heart region. In fact, every thought first gets its shape in the heart itself. Assuming divine light present in the heart is called meditation on the heart. But unfortunately, the heart lost its effulgence on account of deeply enfolded impressions of past many births. Therefore, the heart should be got purified from its solid grossness. This becomes possible only by means of yogic transmission, pranahuti. Therefore, it is necessary for an aspirant to go in search of such a powerful spiritual master who had been blessed with the perfect super sensuous God realization, and he is only be able to accord yogic transmission to his disciples. In Sahaj Marg system of meditation, pranahuti is the most unique and important feature. It is remarkable in this system that the master's every second has all spiritual work in establishing direct connection between divine and aspirant. Here, the master is always with the disciple. Wherever he is physically, he takes the disciple's wholesale responsibility and emboldens him in his onward march towards the ultimate. During this period, Sri Babuji Maharaj protects and guards his disciple similarly a mother protects to its child. The yogic power pranahuti gradually pervades into the sadhaka's vitals of the heart. From there, it expands throughout and takes charge of purification of inner chakras and illumines every system with the divine glow. The latent divinity originally blessed in man is thus awakened and restored him to subtle condition to go forward towards the infinite. Bit of all this course takes place in simplest natural process. Having blended with the total naturality, this mark is above the caste and the religion and the nationality. The master, in order to make his work easy, appoints some selected persons as preceptors and elevates them to a well-fitted spiritual condition. The master accords entry into Sahajamarg system of practice by transmitting the willing persons through these preceptors. After this introduction only, the aspirant gets into direct link with the master and comes competent to absorb pranahuti. Thereupon, the aspirant with the added strength of pranahuti besides his spiritual urge in sadhana, slowly marches forward towards the goal. In these days, a number of Sahaja Marga centers in the name of Sri Ramachandra Mission are working in and outside the country. And each center is attached to a preceptor. There can even be more preceptor in a center. America, England, France, Germany, Denmark, Italy, Egypt, Canada, Africa, Australia, Malaysia, Ceylon, Nepal, etc. are the mission international centers, and there are centers in all important cities in other provinces in India. Hyderabad, Tirupati, Vijayawada, Amalapuram, Nagarjuna Sagar, Nellur, Kavali, Chittur, Rajahmundry, Kakinada, Visakhapatnam, Palavansa, Karimnagar, Bellampalli, Kadapa, Yerragundla are the centers established in Andhra Pradesh. The abhyasi of this system compulsorily should have to follow three principles called dhyana, cleaning and prayer. Meditation in Sahaja Marga is simple. The aspirant every day, early in the morning, at fixed hours, at his convenience, should have to sit in an easy posture with closed eyes for 1 hour, assuming that divine light is present in the heart. At this aspect, he needs no recitation of any incantation. From the moment he sits with closed eyes after prayer, the sadhaka begins to feel by slow degrees the divine wave of pranahuti coming from the beloved master and making room into his heart. His mind fills with undefinable bliss when pranahuti is instilled. Feeling of grass body disappears and prevails a subtle condition. Blood circulation becomes weak. Respiration felt almost feeble. Heart gets mysterious peace and quiescence. It appears as though every bit of body is raining divine glow. Tears begin to proceed. It is not known how much time has passed. Hours pass like minutes. The aspirant feels as though he is being melted into infinity. But consciousness is felt all right. Outside discourses though are audible, but in a weaker tone. But they nothing affect the condition of the aspirant. He associates so much in divine thought that he does not like to come out of this condition. Pranahuti, the divine grace able to melt even stones, slowly travels towards the aspirant, and the aspirant in turn proceed towards divinity. Thus, the whole system to undergo thorough alteration, that is, fear disappears and doubts fade away. Selfishness is smashed and confidence grows. Heart is clean and the mind becomes firm. Day by day, the aspirant with utter discipline, emboldened with optimism, pays upwards crossing the circles of Maya and ego and safely enters into the animating spirit of Sunya. His Holiness Sri Babaji Maharaj assures a fast realization of God to a devoted, enthusiastic aspirant in this very life.